With the introduction of the waveguides. Now, if I want to define what is waveguide, the waveguides are nothing but a hollow metallic tube of uniform cross section for transmitting electromagnetic waves by a successive reflection from inner wall, and it is a tube kind of a structure. That is what we call as a waveguide. So if you go through the structure of a waveguide, you will see this kind of a structure. So this is the waveguide, and if you see the shape, this is a rectangular kind of a shape, and that's why this waveguide will be called as a rectangular waveguide. So whenever wave incident, now if you see the direction of the wave propagation is this one, so whenever wave incident, it will reflect, or it will incident to this inner conductor and they will reflect back again this reflection. So whenever I am talking about the principle of working of this kind of a transmission line, the working principle is a total internal reflection. So because of that total internal reflection, whatever waves that will be carried forward. Okay? So if you are having this kind of a shape with a radius of r, if you are having circular, this kind of a waveguide will be called as the circular waveguide. So if you'll see, these are nothing but the hollow metallic tube like a structure, and they are formed by only single conductor. ठीक है. If you take any example of any conventional line, your structure will be made up of two conductors. One is to carry the positive and other one is to carry the negative kind of things. ठीक है. So but here, whenever you talk about the waveguides, it is having a structure which is a single conductor and enclosed kind of the structure. Now next one is nothing but the waveguides properties. So what are the characteristics of the waveguides? If I'm going to talk about the waveguide, these are nothing but the characteristics of the waveguide. Waveguides like a transmission line are structure used to guide waves from point to point. So transmission takes place from point to point. However, the fundamental characteristics of waveguide and transmission lines are quite different. Why they are different? Because if you see the differences in the geometry, they will allow some mode and they will not allow other modes. Now we'll see what is the mode in latter part. So difference in this mode results from the basic differences in a geometry. So your transmission lines are made up of two conductor, your waveguides are made up of only single conductors, and that's why there will be the difference between the modes. Now waveguides can generally be classified as either metal waveguides or a dielectric waveguides. ठीक है, आप you are either using a metal waveguides or you are going for the dielectric waveguides. Metal waveguides normally take the form of enclosed conducting metal pipe, which I have shown you previously. The waves propagating inside the metal waveguide may be characterized by reflections from the conducting walls. So there is, you can say, a total internal reflection, and that carries your wave from one point to another point. Now advantages of the waveguide. The first advantage is the large surface area of waveguide reduces I square R losses. As there is a large surface area, I square R losses as compared to your coaxial cable will be reduced. If you take the example of a coaxial cable, you are having a, this kind of a structure. You are having an inner conductor, you are having an insulator, after that you are having a mesh conductor, after that you are having a insulator, like this structure you will have. And if you'll see the shape, or if you'll see the size of an inner conductor, very small inner conductor is used over here. Okay, so because of this size, small size, whenever the frequency increases, your current tries to confine on the surface of this inner conductor. Okay, and that gives rise to the skin effect. So here your efficiency will further reduce because of this skin effect if you're going for the coaxial cable. So you can say your coaxial cable will become less efficient for microwave frequencies than the waveguide. Now next advantage is nothing but the light electric losses. So if I'm talking about in between my inner conductor and outer conductor, I have a dielectric material. Okay, so here whatever dielectric material I'm going to use will not be ideal one, and that's why the dielectric losses will come into picture. So dielectric losses can be lowered if you're going to use air as a dielectric medium. Okay, so in waveguides you're going for the air as a dielectric material, and that's why your losses will be low. Okay, now next one is nothing but the radiation loss are low because of the geometry, and as we have seen that whenever the frequency increases, your radiation losses decreases. So here the radiation losses for this transmission line waveguide because of geometry reduces. Power handling capability. So if you see coaxial cable, you can say that there will be the loss of the power because of losses. So here when I'm going for the waveguides, my waveguides can handle more power than the coaxial cable. So these are the advantages. So if I compare my conventional transmission line with the with the waveguide, the first difference comes that two or more conductors, how you're using this, this is not a single conductor, you're going for a two or more conductors separated by some insulating material. Two wire cable, coaxial cable, and microstrip cables, waveguides. These are the metal waveguides, typically one enclosed field with an insulating medium. So probably this medium we are using here as air. This is the first difference. Second difference is nothing but the whenever it comes to the normal transmission line, it supports TEM mode. TEM, transverse electromagnetic mode. It can support TEM and TM mode, but these modes are typically undesirable in this transmission lines. Now about these modes we are going to discuss after this difference. So operating modes are TE or TM mode. If I talk about the waveguide, it supports TE mode and TM mode and cannot support TEM mode. So this is the basic difference you need to remember, that when I deal with a transmission line which is a multi-conductor line, you will have a TEM mode. When I'm going for a single conductor transmission line, it supports only TE or TM mode. Next one is nothing but the, if you're talking about the TEM mode in a transmission line, you will not have any cutoff frequency. But if you're going for the waveguide, you will have the cutoff frequency of TE and TM mode. So these waveguides will operate only above the cutoff frequency, not below the cutoff frequency. So while designing, while taking care of a waveguide, you must take care of the cutoff frequencies of that particular mode. So you need to understand which mode will work and which mode will not work. Now to understand this, we're going to solve a number of numericals to understand which mode will work and which mode will not work. Next one is nothing but this, for a normal transmission line, significant signal attenuation at high frequency due to conductor and dielectric losses. So in between two conductors, you are having dielectric. So there will be the significant signal attenuation at a high frequency because of a skin effect. Here in the waveguide, you are having a lower signal attenuation, okay, than the transmission lines. The next difference tells us that transmission lines are having a small cross-section area like coaxial cable, and that's why they can transmit a low power levels. Okay, and you can say this low power levels due to relatively high fields concentrated at specific location within the device. And when I talk about the waveguides, comparatively you are having a larger cross-sectional area. They are able to handle more power than regular transmission lines. Now again the same difference, large cross-section transmission lines can transmit a high powers. Okay, if you're talking about the large cross-section transmission lines in a conventional transmission lines like parallel wires, like a two wire, like a coaxial cable, it is not possible, or you can say it is impractical to have a large cross-sectional area or large cross-section, and that's why again it will limit the power handling capability. If I talk about the waveguides, large cross-section low frequency waveguides are impractical due to large size and the high cost. So here the limitation will be on the low frequency. So this is all about the transmission, as we call it, as electromagnetic waves. So all transfer components of electric and magnetic fields are determined from axial component of electric and magnetic field in the z direction. So here whenever we talk about the transmission through waveguide, we are assuming some of the things. So first thing we are assuming is nothing but the, our propagation is in the x direction, sorry, in the z direction. So we are assuming that whatever transmission takes place over there is nothing but the in the z direction. Okay, so always we know, or always we call it as my transmission is in the, I can say, z direction. So our first assumption is that your waveguide, I'll just use this short form, waveguide is infinite in length and your transmission is, you can say, it is oriented along the z axis and the transmission is along with the z axis. Okay, and you are assuming another thing, which is nothing but the, your waveguides are constructed from ideal material. So whatever material you are using is nothing but the ideal material, and all fields are time harmonic. So these are our assumptions, so that it is easy for us to understand how that particular waveguide works. So you know that this allows more formation of TE TM and TM and hybrid in the microverse. Now let us have a look at the types of the mode. So the direction of electric and magnetic field component along with the three mutually perpendicular direction, that is in the direction X, that is EXHX, along with the Y, EYHY, along with the Z direction, it will be EZ and HZ. Okay. Now, whenever I talk about the first mode, that is nothing but the transverse electromagnetic mode. So we are like, if I'm talking about this mode, which is the short form, is called as a TEM mode. So in this mode, both electric and magnetic fields are purely transverse to the direction of the propagation. So our direction of propagation is nothing but the Z direction. So when I say my electric and magnetic field is purely transverse to the direction of propagation, means that there is no electric and magnetic field in the direction of the propagation. So I can say my EZ is equal to zero and my HZ is equal to zero. But in other directions, in the X direction and Y direction, I will have these components. Next mode is nothing but the TE mode. The long form of this TE mode is nothing but the transverse electric mode. Similarly, as we have defined it for TEM mode, we can define it for TE mode. So in this mode, your electric field is purely transverse to the direction of the propagation. Okay? If you say that your electric field is purely transverse, means your magnetic field will exist, but your electric field will be zero. So EZ is equal to zero and HZ will not be equal to zero. When I say any field is purely transverse, means that field does not exist in that direction. So in a transverse electric mode, I can say EZ is equal to zero and HZ is non-zero. The third mode or third wave is nothing but the transverse magnetic wave. So similarly, your magnetic field will be purely transverse to the direction of the propagation. So HZ is equal to zero and EZ will have some value. It will be non-zero. Last wave is nothing but the hybrid wave. Now in this wave, neither the electric or the magnetic field is purely transverse to the direction. So both fields are not transverse. So they do exist in that direction. So EZ is non-zero and HZ is non-zero. So this is all about the fields or this is all about the modes which exist in the microwaves. Okay? Now, as we have already gone through this kind of things, multi-conductor lines normally supports TEM mode. Okay. So because of theory of transmission is applicable to only those system of conductors that have a go and return path. So in a multi-conductor, you are having a go and a return path, and those which can support a TEM wave. Okay. Now, when I'm talking about the single conductor lines, it allows TE and TM mode. Okay. So waveguides are single conductor, and because they are having a single conductor, you can have this kind of structure. Open conductors, they guides supports hybrid waves. So it now when I talk about all four modes, I can say waveguides can support TETM, multi-conductor supports TEM, and open waveguide or open conductor structures will support hybrid mode. So these are nothing but the categorization of modes and the transmission lines, which transmission line supports which kind of a mode. Now when I talk about the transmission line, so the conventional open wire transmission line are not suitable for microwave transmission as the radiation losses will be high. So at a microwave frequency, the transmission line employed can be broadly classified into three types. The first type is a multi-conductor lines. So multi-conductor lines, you are having more than one conductor, will be called as a multi-conductor. Coaxial cables, strip lines, microstrip lines, slot lines, and a coplanar lines. So if you see multi-conductor lines, the transmission lines which has more than one conductor are called as a multi-conductor lines. Coaxial line is nothing but the example of multi-conductor line, where you can see this is the mostly used or widely used high frequency transmission line. So this is the structure of your coaxial cable. So the coaxial line consists as an inner conductor with inner diameter D and then a concentric cylindrical insulating material around it. So this is surrounded by an outer conductor, which is a concentric or concentric cylinder with an inner diameter of d. So you this can be realized by using by watching this figure. So this is the outer diameter, this is the inner diameter, and in between inner and outer diameter you are having an insulating material with a dielectric constant of say Er. Okay, so this is the structure of a coaxial cable. Now when it comes to the, I can say, transmission lines of a second time, here if you see this kind of a transmission lines, you are having single conductor lines, that is waveguide. So first is nothing but the rectangular waveguide. So if you see, rectangular waveguides are having this kind of a structure. Okay, a structure as it looks like a rectangle will be called as a rectangular waveguide. So this is, you can say, the breadth, which will be denoted by A. This is nothing but the width, this will be denoted by B. And if it is having a finite length, this distance will be called as the D. Or if you are closing both the sides, will be called as the D. Now this inner, यहाँ पे जो भी है इनर साइड ऑफ दिस दे आर कोटेड विद अ परफेक्ट आई कैन से कंडक्टिंग मटेरियल. यू कैन यूज हियर अ गोल्ड और यू कैन गो फॉर कॉपर काइंड ऑफ थिंग्स. सो प्लैटिनम, सॉरी प्लैटिनम और कॉपर, प्लैटिनम एंड गोल्ड दे आर कोटेड विद. सो वेन एवर द वेव्स enters inside, the total internal reflection is possible. ठीक है, this type of structure is called as a rectangular waveguide. ठीक है, so this is the first waveguide. Second is nothing but the circular waveguide. So when you see circular waveguide, this will also be a hollow metallic tube, but the only difference will be there in the geometry. So this kind of is nothing but the circular waveguide with the, I can say, this is nothing but the radius of that circle. Your third is a elliptical waveguide. If you are having a elliptical shape like this, and if they are connected together, this waveguide will be called as the elliptical waveguide. Single reached waveguide, this waveguide will look like this. So I'm just trying to give you the idea. If you are having this kind of a structure, this will be called as a single reached waveguide. So inside this there will be like aapka ye single reached waveguide hai. And if you are connecting two single reach waveguides, will be called as a double reach waveguide. So this is single reach waveguide, and the, if I want to show you double reach waveguide, your double reach waveguide, I'll try to accommodate it somewhere here. So your double reach waveguide will have this kind of a structure. So I can say this structure is nothing but the double reach waveguide. Inside this you will have this kind of thin layer. So I can see this structure is the double reached waveguide. So these are nothing but the types of the waveguides, out of which we are going to concentrate on the rectangular waveguide. ठीक है, now this is all about the transmission line. Now we'll see how the propagation of waves in the rectangular takes place. So next part, I'm sorry, I have explained you the second type of transmission line, and third type of transmission line is nothing but the open boundary structure which supports the hybrid mode of the waves. So these are the dielectric rods, these are the open waveguides. ठीक है, so such a three type of classification is done here.